Welcome all. We are now in the city center of Amsterdam at the Kennels at the Prinsengracht, nearby our office. And we thought we have a lot of young people. Why not buy a boat for the Friday afternoon? And then after a couple of tours, we found out that it was really difficult to steer because this boat is made to rescue people. And then I met Paul and I thought, hey, why don't we, if we are an artificial intelligence company, why don't we make this boat self-driving? That's where this story starts.
Normally, all vehicle autonomy projects are very heavily into robotics. And here at Somnia, we thought, okay, can we use the power of AI to just streamline that whole process? So this is the first autonomous vehicle purely powered by AI. Right now, we only use a camera combined with an NVIDIA Jetson. And the only thing we use is the video feed from the cameras to determine action. And the video feed is being fed to a neural network, and the neural network predicts the action it needs to take.
To make this boat autonomous, we had to do some adjustments because it was an old diesel boat. So we put two electrical engines in it, also some jet thrusters. And to make the muscles connect with the brain, we use a PLC.
There's two phases to the project. One is training and one is actual deployment. And during training, the only thing we do is we drive through the canals with a human test driver and we collect the steering info from the test driver combined with the video feed from the camera. During the deployment stage of the project, we basically use all the gathered data to train the neural network with the steering info from our test driver combined with the camera images from the camera. When the neural network has been trained and we feed it a new camera image, it will try and predict a new action command based on what it has seen from our original test driver. The whole system is based on AI, even when it comes down to routing and pathfinding. So there's no GPS that determines the true north. It literally only looks at the camera images to determine where it needs to go and what it needs to do. So one of the core strengths, I think, behind the AI approach is the fact that we can get going very quickly. Last year, we made national news with this boat. And for the complete end system, we spent a month gathering data, opposed to years and years of research needed with the robotics approach.
So after this proof of value, we started a joint venture with Shipping Factory, and the name is Shipping Technology, and we're going to make the inland ship autonomous. So now we already are gathering data on one inland ship for 7 months.
The AI doesn't know what it is or what it needs to do. It needs to figure that out during training. So one of the beautiful things about this AI is that it's very generic in purpose. It can power boats, cars, planes, trains, you name it. So the possibilities after this are pretty much endless.